they had the McCarthy hearings back in the 50s, people accused of being Russian agents had a chance to be heard by the committee. But the New America, where the mainstream media is the assassin of the press, and in the New America, you don't get to face your accusers. These committees in the House and the Senate sit there, more than 10 meetings I've watched the last year and a half, and lie about me and say things I never said and never did. And then I have no chance to ever respond. So now every time they have one of these hearings lying about me, lying about InfoWars, I'm going to come and I'm going to have press conferences in D.C. every single time. Because there's a globalist sellout of our country to communist China and espionage carried out by the Democratic Party and many members of the Republican Party as well. That's why I've been targeted. So I can't have a press conference. As you can see in America, cannot face my accusers. That's how it works in this country. There you go. That'll be your newscast. Right here.
Are you detaining Alex? Are you arresting Alex? They said no. This is merely just a conversation that they want to have with him. He's here behind this closed door.
Seriously, do I have a First Amendment? Because they're, you know about authoritarian regimes. They're lying about me and then trying to deplatform me. 26 companies working in concert, violating the Sherman Antitrust Act. And now Senator Warner and Senator Wyden have said, quote, there's thousands of sites worse than Alex Jones. So we're becoming like Cuba, we're becoming like Vietnam, we're becoming like China. So regardless of what people think about me or the straw men, should I have a First Amendment or should these companies be able to violate the whole Safe Harbor Act and all that and then ban conservatives en masse?
Yeah, I don't know anything about your site, man.
No, but about the First Amendment.
Yeah, I support the First Amendment. I just ask questions about it.
I know, you were the only one that brought up China. Are you aware, are you aware of the deplatforming going on?
In China?
No, here. Big tech companies are purging conservatives. They're shadow banning people in mass.
Yeah, well, my broader concern is that what we are trying to do in terms of preventing foreign interference in our elections, that technology could be used by authoritarian governments to argue, we want you to do the same thing against people that are in our country operating. For example, for them, misinformation would be something like the truth. For them, sowing instability would be supporting democracy and free
But the
speech.
Democrats are doing what you said China does.
That you got from Sheryl Sandberg and Jack Dorsey on that question.
I think Facebook now is, I think it's important for them not to comply with any efforts to sort of go after freedom.
But what about the Democrats purging conservatives? She's not answering. Just the Republicans are acting like it isn't happening. Thank God Trump is.
Well, but
that's weird, man.
Oh, yeah, it's really weird. There's no purge of conservatives. There's no shadow banning of members of Congress.
Are you concerned about bias in social media?
Yeah, who's this guy? We deplatformed
him. Concerned about bias in social media.
Well, I think the bigger bias is against freedom of expression. Everybody should be. There's a look,
it's happening here. It's happening here, but you say I don't exist.
Is that a heckler or a prostitute?
Look at this guy. He's saying that I don't exist.
You're not familiar.
And they're deplatforming me.
I just don't know who you are, man.
And they,
I don't know who your website.
Sure. And they demonize me in these very hearings. And then he plays dumb. Infowars.com, you know what it is.
Oh, well. Does Google, does Facebook, does
that's why you didn't get elected.
Do they need to be regulated like, do they need to be regulated?
Marco Rubio, the snake. Little frat boy here.
All right, man.
Yeah.
Who are you? Who is this guy? I swear to God, I don't know who you are.
You better hope you're deplatforming. Tens of billions of views.
Infowars.
Bigger than Rush Limbaugh. He knows who InfoWars is. Playing this joke over here. That's why the deplatforming didn't work.
But here's the question. Here's a question.
Wait, don't touch me again, man. I'm asking you not to touch me.
Well, sure. I just patted you nicely.
I know, but I don't want to be. I don't know.
You want me to get arrested?
I don't know who you are.
It's not as good as my First
arrested,
Amendment.
Man.
It's not just enough to take my First Amendment.
Myself.
Oh, he'll beat me up.
I didn't say that.
You didn't know who I am, but he's so mad. You're not going to silence me. You're not going to silence America.
Well, but there are people.
You are literally like a little gangster thug.
There are people in this country.
Rubio just threatened to physically take care of me.
There are people who feel that they're being silenced. They feel like
he tells you China's the problem, which it is, but they're taking our free speech right now.
Social media platforms, Facebook.
There goes Rubio.
Do you believe that these platforms need to be regulated like a public utility, and how do you go about doing that?
Well, I prefer not to. I prefer competition to take care of that. But obviously, we're going to watch closely to make sure that these tools that are being used. I mean, one thing is to say we're going to go after foreign interference designed to sow instability.
But it's already going on here.
Another thing is to
the
say
Democrats
we're going to
are raping the Republicans.
Because at some point someone has to make a determination of what's the difference between, you know, misinformation from abroad and differences of opinion within the United States.
Yeah, and that's happening
here.
It's
a very fine line, and that's something we need to be careful about. We don't overreach in that direction.
But then he doesn't know about InfoWars being banned. He doesn't know about the top news story in the country.
About how they, not just how they apply that within the United States,
InfoWars.
But they don't become agents of authoritarian regimes abroad to crack down on free speech. Because
I wonder why Rubio got so mad at me and threatened me physically.
There's a balance between what is free speech and what people disagree on.
Okay. Poor Rubio.
I'm sorry, we get it.
Yeah, man, I got to go to the committee.
Exactly.
You guys can talk this clown.
Oh, yeah. Looks a little frat boy. So cool. Go back to your bathhouse. Stop violating my First Amendment in those hearings. Yeah, you guys are a bigger threat to China, the Democratic Party, trying to take my rights and my speech. Shame on you.
Hey, Jack, I appreciate you supporting the First Amendment,
but I have a right to face my accusers, Jack. You are incredibly shameful.
How are you doing?
You're just a, look at you, look what the, you are literally an anti-American, anti-free speech coward. You're going to go down the history books at the Criminal News Network. And these people hate America, folks. You've got to understand how much the controlled corporate left hates this country because they've been sucking off of us forever. And so their culture is hating America. Their culture is knowing that America's ethos is superior. And it is a system of hating America by losers and authoritarian trash. And the authoritarian trash is about to find out that not everybody's scared of them. And I'm taking them on, and I'm willing to be demonized and lied about by the corporate media.